Hey, what's up? This is Anjali, and welcome to the first episode of Non-Fiction November. In this episode, we are going to talk to Keshav Sekseria. Keshav is a good friend and a buddy non-fiction reader who is reading since his childhood and have read more than 80 best non-fiction books. He is an entrepreneur and his company, Catsum, is about to complete 5 years. It was such a beautiful experience for me to watch Catsum grow, but more about it later. And today we will see what made him love nonfiction so much and how those books are helping him in his spiritual journey and in growing his business. In this podcast, he is sharing with us about his immense love and understanding for nonfiction, how he came to be so much practical in his life, and how you should read any nonfiction book to get the best out of it. I personally want you to listen to this podcast till the last second because it's gonna impact you in a different way and it's gonna impact the way you read nonfiction. And do tell me in the comments which thing resonates with you the most. Let's dive in. Due to some technical glitch, he could not be available for a video, but now without any further ado, let's dive in.
Hello Keshav, how are you?
Hi, Anjali. I'm good. How are you?
I'm really good. And thank you so much for taking out time for this series. I'm really grateful to you. So let's start off with...
How many books you have read?
I think it's been almost 8 to 10 years I've been reading. And more than 70, 80 books.
And I'm aware of the fact that you are a non-fiction reader. Like, avid non-fiction reader. Am I right? So, like, in those books that you have read, how many are nonfiction? Like an approx number?
Almost, I guess. Like, hardly 5 to 10 books worth fiction, and most of them are nonfiction. Like, most of the answers that I look in books, I found in nonfiction only.
Oh my God. This is mind-blowing. So, like, what is that thing that made you love nonfiction this much?
See, like, whenever anyone starts with reading, everyone have a purpose. Like, okay, why I'm reading a book? Okay, why I'm a reader?
Yes.
So, like, someone likes to entertain themselves via reading, and someone try to find their answers, like... their personal life answers, their professional life answers, and they want to learn something out of the book. And I think that is a major thing, like why I love nonfiction. Because the major difference between fiction and nonfiction is fictions are not real. They take you to the imaginative world.
Yeah.
And on the other hand, talking about nonfiction, it is more of like a reality check. Like where you study about real life experiences, real problems. So like when you understand the reality, you get a lot of like, we talk about a specific idea of subjectivity.
Yes.
So non-fiction helps you with those things.
This is really true. Like if you read non-fiction with a purpose, then you can get the most out of it.
Obviously, like fiction can help you with your entertainment purpose. Like, obviously, like I'm not criticizing fiction at all. Like, obviously, those stories also have morals and a lot of things. But when you start getting practical in your life, you need more practical experiences. You need more real life stories, which I think like real life concepts and everything. And to increase your thought process, like, okay, if you want to expand your thought process, then obviously you need to read nonfiction. Like, I always say about books, like, books are a preserved mind. You are reading someone's mind. So, like, when you read nonfiction mind, you read mostly real stories, their real life struggles. So, it helps you a lot with your professional career, your personal life experiences, a lot.
Yes. I really love that line that you're reading someone's mind. And like you talked about that you're reading about someone else's life. So can I say that your favorite genre is autobiography or biography?
True, but like I won't specify it. Like truly, I won't specify ki, okay, I read biographies or autobiographies only. But I find it's a complete non-fiction area is my genre. So starting from autobiography, autobiography, biographies, and real life concept book, management books, everything.
Okay, so everything in non-fiction. Almost everything in non-fiction, because there are so many genres in non-fiction that we rarely explore. That is historical.
Yeah, autobiographies and biographies have their very different specific importance. Completely different. Where you learn about their life realities, their life experiences. And while talking about any specific topic, if I want to learn about mind, obviously I can't find it any autobiography or biography. Or if I want to learn about some new tech, or I want to learn some new financial strategy thing, or I want to learn about any Roman history or anything, I can't find it perfectly in any biography. So I need to get some topic books as well.
Wow. So everything about nonfiction. You love everything about nonfiction and every genre, almost every genre. This is really, really nice.
Almost.
So if I ask you, which is that one book which impacted your life the most, which one would it be?
That's a really tough question, because I've read so many. But two books. I'll specify two books. One is the first nonfiction which I read, and it really impacted my life. And the other one is one which I refer everyone. If you want to start with reading, if you want to start with your reading journey or anything, reading, if you want to pursue any career or anything that you need in life, I will refer that one book. So talking about the first book that I read is How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie.
Oh, yes. That book is a gem.
Yeah. So because I still remember, I got that book by my principal in school, because I was very much into entrepreneurship thing and leadership thing. And she knew that, I'll be interacting with a lot of people in my life. Right. So she referred me that book. Okay, you should read that book. And really, that book helped me a lot to build my team, to maintain my relationship with my clients, with my colleagues, and everyone. If you want to stand in this world, you need that book. You need that book if you want people to stand with you, to make them listen and believe in you, your ideology, everything. You need to win friends. And if you want to influence the world, you need that book. I'm damn sure most of the influencers in the world have read that book, How to Win Friends and Influence People. And the second book which I would love to talk about is, beginning of this conversation, I started, the complete conversation started with purpose. Why would someone read a book? Why? So why is a very big thing? So the very first book I suggest anyone to read is Start With Why by Simon Sinek.
Both are
Start With Why. Because exactly, I would like to talk a lot about Start With Why, because in that particular book, you find out a lot about you, why you want to do anything. You find your answers. Okay, you want to start reading? Why? Okay, you want to start a business? Why? Okay, you want to eat a food? Why? Okay, you want to pursue this habit? Why? Find why in everything. And once you get your purpose, once you get your why, you put all your heart and soul to achieve that thing.
This is really true. I love this line. This is the second line of the podcast that I love.
So these are the my personal two recommendations. First one is How to Win Friends and Influence People, and then Start With Why. Okay. Or Finding Your Why, the exact title of the book.
So today we know that what drives you, and we know that how you are a great listener and a great communicator. Finally, we have the secret.
Yeah.
So there's a major difference in the behavior in we can see the different mindsets of people who read more nonfiction and who read more fiction. We cannot just discard fiction, because fiction has its own advantages, like it enhances our creativity and so many things are there. But what is one major difference you feel you had in you, or you have in you right now, that came from reading nonfiction?
I became more practical in my life.
Okay, as you read more and more nonfiction.
Nonfiction. Yeah. The reason, because when we talk about fiction, like I mentioned this earlier, we are more into imaginative world.
Yeah.
And more dangerously, we are into someone else's imaginative world, not ours.
Yeah.
Like I mentioned, like books have preserved mind. We are diving into someone else's imaginative world.
Yes.
Like if you will see here, like statistics say, like on Netflix, like most of the content that people are seeing are now nonfiction. Like people are driving towards more non-fiction things. And also in the Bollywood industry, people have started creating non-fiction movies. They have just started picking up non-fiction content or scripts. Because fiction drives you into imaginative world. And you lack practicality over there. Your real life decisions, real problems and everything. Like, obviously, they carry moral, they carry their own importance. Creativity is a very well-mentioned thing, which fiction have their own importance. But non-fiction carries that practicality and that fact and that particularly specific idea of subjectivity that people need to, like, fight this world or to live their life. You can't be in your imaginative world. Like, hard to truth, but like life is very hard. Life is very hard. There are a lot of obstacles in every path. Like, if you're pursuing your career, your business, your personal relationship, or anything, you need a mentor. You need a mentor to guide you with their life experiences. And it's not always possible to get a mentor in every specific field. But yes, non-fiction books are available in every specific field with their real life experiences, with their life practical examples.
This is really true. Like, everything to the point. So, like you talked about practicality, and I know that you are a spiritual person. You are growing into spirituality day by day. So, is there any book that is helping you right now that in your spiritual journey?
Autobiography of a Yogi.
Wow, that book has helped me a lot as well.
So that book carries a lot. Like, that's so heavy book. It's so heavy book, like, it will help you a lot. It will help you a lot. And I have nothing much to say beyond that. That book carries a lot of thing inside it, and every single page. And the best part about that book is, like, I literally quote you, like, Autobiography of Yogi is completely like Gita, for me at least. Like, every time you read that book, every time you read any page, again and again, you'll find new things out of that. Like, if you read like one page for three times, you learn three new things.
I don't know what to say about it, because that book is really capable of changing you, is really capable of guiding you in the right direction. And people...
It can change your life completely.
Yes, it can. And I really want to say this to my listeners, that we both recommend you, like, highly recommend you to read Autobiography of a Yogi, because that book can change your life forever if you let it.
Yes.
So, like...
And, like, few more books which I really want to mention.
Yeah.
I don't want to miss out this book. I just mentioned this, Gita.
Yes.
So when we talk about non-fiction, when we talk about spirituality, okay, Gita is at top post. So you can't find any better book than Gita when you are trying to explore spirituality. And then one more book. Okay, yeah, I know I'm mentioning a lot of books, but when we talk about spirituality, you can't find your answers in one book.
Yes.
So, The Journey Within by Radhanath Swami.
Okay. This is, I'll check about it. I don't know about this book much.
When we talk about spirituality, as I mentioned, you try to look through you. You want to see within you. And you try to figure out a lot about yourself. So none other than The Journey Within, it will help you a lot.
Okay, I will definitely check this book out. And there is this one thing that I want to mention, and this is a myth about nonfiction. People think that they are going to read one book, and by following all the things in that book, they are going to be a complete new person. While this is, this is the most impractical thing. You can read a book about communication and you can improve your communication through that, but you cannot expect to be a complete different person even though you're following all the things. I think that it is a complete package. You read more and more about different things and you build yourself up through the process. What do you think about it?
To start with this, I want to mention about... books are preserved mind. You are reading someone else's mind. So you can't, this is a warning I give to everyone when they enter into nonfiction world or they enter into reading world. When you are reading someone else's mind, you can't believe everything written in that book. First thing, you can't believe everything written in that. So while reading any book, you have to be a very, very, very practical analyst at first place. When you are reading a book, you have to read that book as a third party. You need to read that book and you need to analyze with all your skills that, okay, is that written in the book, everything is good or not? Should I adapt it in my life or not?
Yes.
Because when I talk about autobiography or my biographies, you can find the biography of Gandhi as well, and you can find autobiography of Hitler as well.
Yes.
So you need to understand the difference. You need to understand things. You need to analyze things written in those books.
Yeah.
See, things are never easy. You'll read a book and it will change your life. You'll read one book and it will change your life. This is a very big myth, or I completely don't believe in this. You need to read a lot of books. You need to understand things written in that book. You need to be a very good analyzer, analyst. Okay, how will I will implement those things in my life? How will it impact my life? And you have to be a very good analyst. You don't have to be driven by anything written in any book. Because everyone has their different life, their different life experience, different environment, different friends. So, and different capabilities, different potential, different life areas, lot of things. So you have to be a very good analyst as per my thinking.
Wow. Moving forward, in your opinion, what Nonfiction November is about? What are your thoughts on Nonfiction November?
It's a good start. It's really a good start. Seeing the current scenario where people are getting driven more and more into imaginative world, lacking their real life experiences, they need to grow their mind. They need to nourish their mind a lot. So it's a good start to encourage people to read nonfiction and improve their life.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for your time. I'm really grateful.
Thank you for having me. I really know how much struggle you have gone through to get this call done. So
have a great day and have a happy Nonfiction November.
Okay, sure. Thank you. Same to you.
I have dropped all his social media links in the description. You can text him for any query that you have, and I suggest just spam him. And if you want to hear from him again about anything, personality development, content writing, marketing, business, sales, spirituality, so many things. You can check his profile, and if you want anything specific, then you can let us know and we'll bring him back. I'll see you guys next time. Happy reading, happy nonfiction November, and bye-bye.